17 rounds is kind of hard to cut back. In 17 out. It was kind of hard pulling it back with the 17th round in there. There's another one with 17 rounds and hollow points. It just went forward on its own, like most polymer guns do sometimes. I'm gonna put 17 more on each one and see how it goes. Alright guys, I tried to put 17 in again, it just didn't feel normal, it felt messed up. But 16 goes in easy, so 16, I'm gonna try. I'm pushing it up and bringing the slide forward. Going forward on its own. When I 15 doesn't send a slide home, so maybe that means something. Find a sweet spot, guys, on the sights. It's butter all day. Have a hole this big around the head area. Headshots. I think it's like 10 yards. But let's keep going. I'm loving it, guys. All right, guys. I'm back. I'm gonna go ahead and just keep putting 15 rounds. I'm not gonna 17. Ghost is going home again on the smack. But keep going. The ejection seems to be about the same. I don't see a big difference. Wait, did I mention I was wearing? Butter. Everything you need is already built in.
say. We were
slide didn't lock back on some Winchester white box. Another 10 rounds. Feeling that I'm riding the slide release. When I'm shooting, I feel my thumb on it. Now I'm not pressing on it. I don't think I am consciously, but it's a possibility that I could might have put enough pressure on it to let it slide. So I'm gonna shoot again. I'm gonna completely leave my finger off of it. See if I have the same problem. It might just be me, guys. Alright, this is the bag that throw it to lock back twice in a row. I only put 10 rounds in here. I'm gonna shoot again. I'm gonna shoot my finger completely off the release. Slide lock back. I put my finger about an inch ahead of the release. I'm going to shoot the mag the same way. See if I have any problems. Guys, I'm gonna continue to shoot the rest of this 100 round box the same way, my thumb in the front, so I have any more faders back to slide. I have to bring it with me, guys. Alright, guys, another two mags. Finger moved up a little bit off the release. Slide locked back, no problems. Again, guys, no problems with the slide locking back now that I've adjusted my grip. Have it, guys. So it wasn't the wet thing. My grip riding that slide release, and naturally it's gonna go forward. Another thing, guys, this is the next 300 rounds. I haven't had any faders, no fader to eject, no stovepipes, no faders at all other than mines because of my grip. But the first time I shot it, I had a couple of fader to ejects. The round didn't come all the way out of here, the case. But now it's been perfect, so maybe it's been properly broken in already. Let's keep going. I'm not gonna lie, guys, gun shit. You do your part, you get on the money. Exactly. Whoop. It happened again. But I just realized I had it. Unknowingly, I had my finger near the damn slide release again. When I looked down, my finger was right on it. I don't know if I was pressing it. It's very sensitive, I guess. I guess when there's no pressure against it, you just barely touch it and it won't lock the slide back. But that was me again, pushing the slide release. That's not good though, because I'm doing it unknowingly. Oh well. Alright, guys, wrapping it up. Remember, I'm gonna keep my finger off the slide release. Finger off the slide release, no problems. Anyways, light lock back, guys. 300 rounds, butter, no problems, no failures. Really good, very accurate, very comfortable to hold everything. It came out of the box with the sights locked on. SAR9, guys, Turkey weapons coming out. Really, really good quality. Stay tuned, because I got a little surprise for y'all. Maybe in about a week or so. A nice little high capacity 45. Anyways, guys, for now, I might have to go home and review the extractions, the ejections and stuff. See how that goes. Some of them did hit me up here, some of them went here. For the most part, I thought most of them went this way. And nothing very weak, but I had to keep an eye on it. I'll look at the video and see. All of you guys saw for yourself, so maybe locking it back for a week or so like this helps that spring loosen up maybe a little bit. Alright, guys.